I love Ohio. It's great to be back in Ohio. Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much. This is a truly great state with thousands of hardworking, wonderful, beautiful American patriots. Beautiful. Under Republican leadership, America is being respected again. And all of those thousands of people that aren't under this shell that are standing out there, look at you. Look at you. They're getting very wet. Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you. There are thousands of people that can't see a thing. In other words, you're better at real estate than they are, but that's okay. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. I'm really proud to report that earlier today, we secured the release of Pastor Andrew Brunson from Turkey. He is now free from jail, and he is in the air, heading to Germany, where he'll get off for a brief check, and I think he's going to be in great shape. And then he's coming to Washington, D.C. tomorrow, and we'll say hello to him. He went through a lot, you know, all about Pastor Brunson. He went through a lot, but he's on his way back. We've done that with a lot, right? We've had a lot of success. North Korea, Egypt, remember? Aya. We bring a lot of people back, and that's good. They want to come back to our country, and they're coming back to our country. Tonight, every American heart is with our fellow citizens affected by Hurricane Michael. Sounds like a very nice name. That was a vicious hurricane. Whether it's in Florida or Georgia, Alabama, North Carolina, South Carolina, a lot of areas affected, but we just want to give everybody our love. That was a devastating power that hit among the most powerful hurricanes ever to hit our country. It was devastating, but they'll rebuild. They're strong. They're great people. And just God bless you all. Thank you. My administration has been in constant communication with the state and local authorities all over the various states. When we're in trouble, we pull together. We pull together like nobody. We're here tonight to discuss the extraordinary achievements that we've made together in, can you believe it, less than 2 years? It's been Republican leadership, and we are here to make sure that our amazing progress continues full speed ahead. Because America is booming, America is thriving, and America is winning, really winning again. And we are viewing now, for the first time in many decades, a phenomenon called, so simply, America First. And it's about time. It's about time, right? About time. It's about time. The unemployment rate has just fallen to the lowest level in more than 50 years. Manufacturing confidence, just announced, has reached an all-time high. Think what that matters. Think what that is. Confidence. Confidence. The people of Ohio have confidence. Can tell you that. No, but think of it. If you remember, the previous administration said manufacturing jobs. Other than that, you like them very much, right? But remember, they said manufacturing jobs, they're gone, they're dead. Remember the expression, you'd need a magic wand to bring them back. We're bringing them back. I guess we have the magic wand. They're coming back. And they're coming back from Mexico. They're coming back from Canada. They're coming back from everywhere because they all want to be where the action is. They all want to be in the USA. That's where we want to be. That's where the jobs are. We are now the hottest country anywhere in the world. All across By the way, I wish the cameras would get this crowd. This crowd is incredible. Look at the cameras back there. It's like the Academy Awards. Look at this. How would you like to have to do this every night? No, how would you like to have to do this every night? And one little mistake, and they try to destroy your entire career. Boy. No, I mean, look at this. Seriously, look at the magnitude of it. Look at the number of the media back there. Look at that. Fake news. Fake. You go back and they'll say, did he say this or that or this? That's okay. You know what? We've learned how to live with them. We've learned how to live with them. We don't like it, but we've learned. All across Ohio, steel mills are reopening, and we are putting our coal miners back to work. One of the things we're most proud of, look, steel was dead. Steel was dead. I came into office, steel was a dead business. Now they're opening up plants, U.S. Steel, Nucor. They're opening up plants all over the country, big ones, new ones. We're taxing the hell out of the dumpers. You know, you had the dumpers that were hurting your steel industry. And you know what happens. After the industry dies, would have died within 2 years, after it dies, they would come in and they would charge you 3 times more money. Nobody says it, but that's what happens. So we're going to have beautiful, new, American-made steel. It's not going to be mud or it's not going to be sand steel. You know, they put garbage in this stuff they were dumping. We don't even know what's in it. It's going to be U.S. steel. It's going to be American steel. We're going to get the iron ore from our mines, right? Beautiful. They're opening up again. Our mines are opening up again. Metallurgic coal. But our miners are back to work. We don't need outsiders telling us about our steel industry. It's incredible. Seriously, it's incredible what's happened. It's hot as a pistol. After years of rebuilding foreign nations, we are finally rebuilding our nation, which is what we want. And this has been... So this has been a really historic week for America. Really historic. And by the way, our magnificent First Lady Melania just returned from an incredibly successful trip to Africa. It was an incredible trip, and she came back and she told me, so beautiful, and yet such incredible, in some cases, poverty. They need help. They definitely need help. It's both beautiful and sad. It's got every kind of emotion. But you probably saw her travels. They were really incredible. And it opens your eyes to what's going on around the world. You're all very lucky in Ohio, that I can tell you. That I can tell you. Thank you. And on Monday night in the East Room of the White House, we achieved a tremendous victory for our nation, our freedom, and our Constitution. America watched as we proudly swore in the newest member of the United States Supreme Court, Justice Brett Kavanaugh. Did he get treated badly and unfairly, or what? Horrible. And I'll tell you what, he's done us a tremendous service. The way they treated him, I've never seen anybody treated like that. But he's done us a great service because we are more energized as Republicans than ever, I think ever before. We just got poll numbers for some of the Senate races. And you look at some of these Senate races where we weren't even going to contest. It's a Democrat that's in. We were figuring, you know, we're winning with candidates that are fit. We're winning. We're beating people that we weren't going to contest. So it's been amazing. Because people realize how important the Supreme Court is. And we could have two, three, maybe even four more choices, and we have to be able to get the votes to put them through. Go out and vote November 6th. From the moment Brett Kavanaugh was announced, an angry Democrat mob was on a mission to resist, obstruct, delay, demolish, and destroy him. And before they even know, I'll tell you, you saw it. Before they knew his name, they were saying horrible things. They didn't even know who was going to be the pick. He wasn't picked. I didn't know who was going to be the pick. And they were saying horrible, horrible things. These are bad people. We can't let this happen to our country. Republicans believe in the rule of law, not the rule of the mob. That's what it is. It's a mob. The people of Ohio can save America from radical Democrats. They become radicalized. I mean, Pocahontas, Elizabeth Warren, seriously. No, no, seriously. She's becoming mainstream. You believe that one? We have to elect a Republican House and a Republican Senate. We need the votes. We need the votes. And by the way, for the people of Ohio, early voting starts right now. You got to get out. Vote early. And then anybody that votes early, you can leave. The hell with you. That's. You know, I worked in Cincinnati, Ohio, two summers. Right? I loved Ohio. I shouldn't tell you this, but I used to travel a lot to Kentucky. Does anybody travel to Kentucky? No, I don't. I like Kentucky. But I traveled to Kentucky, but I spent a lot of time in the Queen City. I love the Queen City. We had a job, Swifton Village. Swifton. Does anyone ever hear of Swifton? And it was a great experience. It was a successful experience. I did it with my father, one of my earliest things that I've done. And I guess it's sort of like if you get your first up as a hit, you're a hitter, you hit. You sink the 10-foot putt on the first hole. But we had a great success in Ohio, and I've never forgotten it. And then they said, remember, for months before the election, you cannot win without getting the great state of Ohio, right? And I got the great state of Ohio, and I love the great state of Ohio. We got it. We got it. Remember? They used to say that every time I used to hear it. I have fantastic people in Ohio that did a job for me. Bob Paduchek, where's Bob? I had just a great group of people. They did incredible work, but they constantly would say on these phony networks, you cannot win unless you win the great state of Ohio. And then they started doing polls, and I was way up. And I think we won it by 9 or 10 points, a lot. We won it by a lot. In fact, you know the way, if it's close, they have to take hours and hours and hours, right? So with Ohio, I'll never forget, they said, the polls have closed in Ohio. Donald Trump has won the state of Ohio. It's crazy. We won Ohio by so much that it took 1 second before they called it, okay? We won by a lot. It's a great place. And by the way, have I produced? Look at what's coming into Ohio now. Have we produced? I produced, and you produced. If Nancy Pelosi and the Democrats take control, they will try to raise your taxes, impose socialism on this country, take away your health care, and take away your jobs. We have more people working now than ever before. They want to take away. That's what will happen. The Democrats want to erase America's borders and let drugs, gangs, and crime pour into our country. In fact, I've been going around lately saying the Democrats are the party of crime, and nobody even challenges me, not even the fake news media. They don't even challenge me. Republicans are the party of safety, and Republicans are the party of jobs, jobs, jobs. And that's what's happening. And we're honored to be joined tonight by many terrific Ohio Republicans, including Republican Party Chair. I have to say, this woman is incredible. Because, you know, I got dropped just before the election by the head of the Republican Party. I've never been dropped in my life. And a woman came in who is a very successful person with a great family. And she took that thing over. What a job she's done. Her name is Jane Timken, and she is very special. Where's Jane? She's incredible. Thank you very much. And a man who said, oh, you're going to win. You're going to win. And I said, well, how do you know? So I had 5 people to choose from to head up my campaign in Ohio. And one name, I don't know, I like the name. I like the sound of it. His name was Bob Paduchek. Why do I like that name? Why? It's not outstanding. But he came in, and he did a job. And I had the support of the people, but not the support of a lot of others, and he just said, you're going to win. And every time I called him up and say, you know, this happened, that happened, he says, that's okay, you're going to win by more. This guy's the most positive guy, so I want to thank Bob Paduchek. So good that we moved them over to the RNC. But, Bob, in about a year from now, get ready. You're coming back here. Thank you, Bob. And we have a friend of mine who's an incredibly respected man in the United States Senate. When he speaks, we all listen, including the president. He really is. He's a great, great guy. He's loved in Ohio, Senator Rob Portman. He's a respected guy. Thank you, Rob. Congressman Warren Davidson and Congressman Brad Wenstrup. Thank you. Thank you, fellas. Great job. So many things we passed in Congress. Those two guys were there with us. Thank you very much. What a job they've done. We're also joined by your next Lieutenant Governor, John Husted. John, thank you. Thank you, John. And I hear you're up a little bit, John. We got to get that over because you're going against a very bad guy. I'll tell you, he's a bad guy. And everybody, I'll tell you, John is with a friend of mine, and they decided to get together, which is very smart. And instead of going like this to each other, they got together. And John is running with your next governor, Mike DeWine. And Mike and John are running against Elizabeth Warren's far-left disciple, Richard Cordray. John, am I allowed to say some bad things about Cordray? Because let me tell you, he did such a bad job at the agency that he ran. It was terrible. He was hurting people, and I think he enjoyed it. No, really, I really believe he enjoyed it. He was putting people out of business. They weren't loaning money to the people that they were supposed to. It was terrible. Cordray spent $250 million federal dollars trying to renovate a headquarters, his agency, that they didn't even own, more than twice what the entire building was worth. They didn't own it. And then it became a big scandal, but because he was a Democrat, the fake news didn't want to write about it. Then after spending like $50 million on some elevators, it turned out that they didn't work. If Cordray were ever, and I'll tell you what, this is a Pocahontas dream to get this guy elected. I can't believe, you know, I know Ohio pretty well, right? I've done a lot for the steel industry, more than anybody's done in many, many. I mean, you speak to U.S. Steel, they'll tell you. A lot for the miners, a lot for everybody. This guy does not belong in the state, folks, okay? First of all, he's a super liberal. Why do you do that? Why do you do that? Is he? Okay, go with DeWine, please. And John. Cordray would be an absolute disaster for Ohio. He doesn't know what the hell he's doing. I couldn't wait to get him out. We tried so hard. You know, he had one of these deals that you couldn't get him out. But we tried so hard, and they've done such a great job since we got him out. He was bad. You don't need him in Ohio. Now, I'm thrilled to introduce the next United States Senator from Ohio, Jim Renacci, who's a great guy and a great friend of mine. Jim, come up. Come up. This is a good man. Nothing's easy about politics, but I'll tell you what, he's in there fighting, and just get out and vote for him. He is a good, good friend of mine and a good man.
Thank you, Mr. President. It's an honor to stand here with you tonight like I stood with you 31 months ago when you were candidate, Trump. And I told you I'm with you. I told you I voted for you. I told you my wife voted for you. My family voted for you. My friends voted for you because we needed you to change Washington. and you haven't let me down. Look, this crowd loves you. Ohio loves you, and we love what you're doing. You've got the Ohio economy growing. Unemployment is down. Wages are up. The Tax Cut and Jobs Bill is working in Ohio. You have two Supreme Court judges confirmed and more circuit judges confirmed than any other president. You've repealed the individual mandate that was hurting so many individuals here in Ohio. Renegotiated NAFTA, helping Ohio business. Passed Right to Try. ISIS is on the run. And you have given our coal miners here in Ohio hope by reversing those devastating policies of the prior administration that had vowed to bankrupt that industry. Promises kept, promises made, promises kept. Look, Mr. President, we are not tired of winning here in Ohio. And yet you've been able to do all that with no help from Ohio Senator Sherrod Brown. He has fought you every turn, voting against the tax bill, voting against coal miners, voting against your judges' confirmations. You asked for help, and that's why I jumped in this race 7 months ago, and I am here to help, just like Ohio. Everyone here is here to help. Sherrod Brown votes 96% of the time with Chuck Schumer and 94% of the time with Elizabeth Warren. Yet he voted 100% of the time with President Obama's judge appointments. He supported Hillary Clinton for president. And even though you are ripping up those trade agreements that aren't working for Ohio, Senator Brown had the gall just a month ago to say the only thing President Trump has done for trade policy is run his mouth and line his pockets. That's the type of guy who is not helping this president. Sherrod Brown is the fourth most liberal senator in the country. That's not Ohio. That's not even close to the average American. He votes like a Hollywood liberal, and he has received the most lobbyist money in the Senate, more than any other senator. He has received the most lobbyist dollars. Look, it's time we send Sherrod Brown packing. And it's time we send me to Washington. Someone that's willing to help this president. In 25 days. In just 25 days, we need to retire Sherrod Brown. We need a red wave, not only a red wave, and I said this earlier, Mr. President, Ohio is going to deliver a red tsunami. Thank you for what you're doing, Mr. President, and thank you for what you've done for Ohio.
Thank you. Thanks, Jim. It is true. Sherrod Brown's never voting for us. He didn't vote for anything that we want. Yet I hear he goes around, he does the best commercials for him. In fact, I sort of think, is he a Republican? He's doing these commercials that he likes Donald Trump. He'll never vote for us. He didn't vote for Justice Kavanaugh. He didn't vote for tax cuts. He doesn't vote for us, folks. I mean, it might be nice for him to say he agrees with my economic policy, but he's never going to vote for it. So you're just kidding yourself. He voted yes on amnesty for illegal aliens. He voted yes on deadly sanctuary cities. We started building the wall, and we've made progress, but he voted against it. So illegal immigration takes American lives, American jobs, and American taxpayer dollars. A border wall, which is moving faster than anybody would believe, is truly a life-saving barrier against deadly floods of drugs, crime, smugglers, traffickers, cartels. Our brave border agents want a wall. They need a wall. It's happening. It's moving. We have made so much progress. We will finish the wall. If you want more jobs and less crime, if you want to stop Schumer from running the Senate, we need the vote of Jim Renacci. We do. Jim is a good person. He's a great guy. We need his vote. You know, they say we have a majority, but if somebody has a cold, they can't come in, we don't have a majority anymore. We got to get people. We got to get some Republicans so we can vote. Finally, it's my privilege to introduce a tremendous Ohio Republican. We're here for him tonight. A great friend of mine. He's fought so hard for everything we've done. He's a true fighter for the state, Congressman Steve Chabot. Great guy. Come up, Steve. Come up, Steve.
Thank you, Mr. President, and God bless Warren County! All right, yeah, all right. And God bless Hamilton County, too. I have Hamilton County, and Butler County as well, and the Kentuckians, and all of you. God bless you all, and God bless President Trump! All right. Thank you. And I never knew I'd say this, but God bless Kanye West. Hey, you know how many liberals it takes to screw in a light bulb? None, because they prefer to stay in the dark. So. Let me just say, I got about a 6-page speech here. I decided the more Steve Chabot you get, the less President Trump you're going to get. So I'm not going to give this speech. God bless you all, and God bless President Trump.
Thank you, Steve. So just remember, a vote for Steve Chabot is a vote to protect your family, your jobs, and your country. Now, Steve's winning. Nice poll numbers. But don't take any chances. Get out and vote, please, okay? No chance. We don't want to hear about any upsets. He's a great, great guy. If you want to stop the radical Democrats, if you want to stop Nancy Pelosi from becoming Speaker, can you believe it? then you have to get out and vote for Steve. Also at stake in this election is Medicare. Democrats have signed up for a socialist takeover of American health care that would utterly destroy Medicare and rob our seniors of the benefits they paid into their entire lives. Republicans want to protect Medicare for our great seniors who have earned it and they've paid for it. And the Democrats want radical socialism, and they want open borders where everybody pours into our country. That's what they want. I don't get it, but that's what they want. Does anybody want that? Open border. The new platform of the Democrat Party is to abolish ICE. Think of that. I'll tell you what. The incredible men and women of ICE are not treated properly. They're not treated properly. They do an incredible job. The Democrats want to turn America into a giant sanctuary city for criminal aliens, MS-13 killers, and anybody else that wants to come in. We're not going to have it. We're not going to have it. Republicans believe our country should be a sanctuary for law-abiding Americans, not criminal aliens. This election is about safety and it's about prosperity. Since the election, which is incredible, if I would have said this, I've been to Ohio so many times, been to every part of Ohio, the people are great, but if I would have said this, the fake news would have said, how dare he say that? Since the election, we've created over 4.2 million new jobs and lifted over 4 million Americans off of food stamps. Big deal. That's a big deal. We've added nearly 600,000 brand new, beautiful manufacturing jobs, right? African-American unemployment has reached its lowest level in the history of our country. And African-American poverty has reached its lowest rate ever. Lowest rate ever. My, it's a big number, right? How do they beat that number? How does anybody beat that number? We're going to have these people come in. For over 100 years, they've claimed and they've wanted and they've said they've lied to African Americans. Remember my statement, what do you have to lose? Guess what? They all believe it now. What do you have to lose? They're doing, we are doing great as a country. But I'm so proud. I am so proud of the kind of numbers you're hearing. My administration is fighting every day to deliver safety, opportunity, and justice for everybody, for everybody. We're asking, as an example, all African-American voters to honor us with their support this November. Get away from the Democrats. Get away from the Democrats. They've done nothing. They've done nothing. Think of it. We have the best numbers in history on employment and unemployment and median income and many other things. And I think we're going to get the African-American vote. And it's true. Kanye West, what he did was pretty amazing yesterday. Pretty amazing. And you know who else was with him? A guy you know well, Big Jim Brown. Big Jim. What do you think Big Jim would be making today in the NFL? He was unstoppable, right? Unstoppable Jim Brown. He was a great football player, and he's an even greater man. He's great. Hispanic Americans and Asian Americans, likewise, have the lowest unemployment in the history of our country. And women unemployment just fell to 3.6%. Which is soon to be changed to historic levels, but right now, I'm sorry, It's the lowest in 65 years, okay? Sorry. Sorry, women. I let the women down. The only reason to vote Democrat is if you're tired of winning, right? Tired of winning. Last week, I announced that we are replacing the horrendous NAFTA. NAFTA was a disaster, folks. NAFTA was a disaster. With the incredible brand new U.S.-Mexico-Canada trade agreement, the USMCA, it's opening up Canada, opening up Mexico for our farmers, our everybody. We've taken the toughest ever action to crack down on China's unfair trade actions and trade abuses. And thanks to our tariff, and especially on steel that's been dumped all over this country, the Ohio steel industry and the U.S. steel industry is roaring back to life and soon will be hitting its most successful years ever. Very soon. And you see it. You see it all over the state. Under Republican leadership, we passed the biggest package of tax cuts and reforms in American history. And by the way, Sherrod Brown voted against them. We reduced high-dose opioid prescriptions by 16% during my first year, and now they're dropping much lower than that. And I'll soon sign into law the largest legislative effort in history to address the opioid crisis, where just this year, we got $6 billion from Congress, thanks to Rob Portman and a lot of others. Thank you, Rob. But Rob and so many others helped. Very little Democrat support. We also passed Veterans Choice, the VA, giving our veterans the right to see a private doctor, and the landmark VA accountability law to ensure anyone who mistreats our veterans, who we couldn't fire, we couldn't do anything about it, we now look at them and say, Jim, you're fired. Out. Get out. We secured $700 billion and $716 billion for the second year to fully rebuild the American military, which had to happen. We needed it. And much less importantly, when it comes to the military, every bit of equipment is being built in the USA. That's the only place where jobs are secondary. Number one, we needed the equipment. But it's all being built here. We make the greatest military equipment in the world. At my direction, the Pentagon is now working to create the sixth branch of the American Armed Forces called the Space Force. Very important. Very important. That's very important. Hate to say it, but very soon, that's where it's going to be at. It's going to be space, everything. Defense, offense, everything. And we have tremendous support from Rob and the Senate. I withdrew the United States from the horrible, one-sided Iran nuclear deal. And look what happened to Iran. You know, when I took office, Iran was all over the place. They were taking over Syria, they were taking over Yemen, they were taking over everything. I actually said, this is going to be a problem, and we got to do something. And about 4 months ago, we withdrew from that horrible, ridiculous deal. And you take a look what's happening to Iran. There's riots all over the streets, all over the cities. It's a whole different ballgame. It's a whole different country, and it's looking real good. Looking real good. And we have recognized the capital of Israel and reopened the American embassy in Jerusalem. Together, we've made unbelievable progress, and we're just getting started. We have so many other things. If you vote to elect Republican House, Republican Senate, we will continue to cut your taxes, cut your regulations, and raise your incomes very, very substantially. We will protect Medicare, and we will protect your Social Security. The Democrats cannot do it. We will continue to confirm judges who interpret the Constitution as written. We will fully secure the border. We will pass Kate's Law, crack down on sanctuary cities, end the visa lottery, and chain migration, defend the ballot box for American citizens, and throw vicious MS-13 gangs the hell out of our country like we're doing right now. Out of here. You know, I say it to people, MS-13, gang, vicious, horrible people. We're throwing them out of here by the thousands. But you know who's doing it? Do we love law enforcement or what? But you know who's... But ICE, in Long Island, where I sort of grew up, I was right next to these areas, I know them so well, you had towns that were practically taken over by MS-13. And ICE goes in like it's a day in the office. And they're tougher and smarter than these wise guys. And they start throwing them in the paddy wagon, throwing them in, get the hell out of here. And you know what? The towns are liberated. The people are clapping from windows. The people are clapping all over the streets. These towns, like a country that was invaded and taken over and then was liberated. These towns are being liberated of the MS-13 garbage that came into our country. Under the previous administration, by the way. And they came in by the tens of thousands. Well, we have set every record on getting them out. And I want to tell you, there's nothing that gives me more pleasure. And for all of the companies that are moving back into the United States, we will finally have a merit-based system of immigration, not just luck, not a lottery. Pick them out of a hat. Who the hell are they? Who is he? Pick them out of a hat. We're letting people come in on merit, where they can help you, where they can help these companies grow. Right now, we have a system, lottery, think of it, lottery. Oh, pick them, I wonder. What people do you think these countries are putting in? Do you think they're putting in their finest? I don't think so. So we're gonna end it. We're gonna have a merit-based system. Bring them in through merit. We're lifting millions of people from welfare to work, dependence to independence, and poverty to prosperity. And you see that happening. But to achieve this, you have to get out November 6th or vote early and vote Republican. We need the votes. We have to have those votes. For years and years, you've watched as your leaders apologize for America. They apologize for us. Now you finally have a president who is standing up for America. To tell you, I wish these fakers back there, the fake news, I wish they'd turn the cameras and show behind them, show outside these walls. Look at the people out there. It's amazing. Look, they never turn the cameras. I go home, I say to my wife, how did the crowd look? They only show your face. They never move the camera. But you know what? She can tell by the sound. Because true. She can tell by the sound. Because, you know, if you have, like, let's say one of the normal presidents walk in, we've had a lot of normals, and some great ones, you'd have, what, 300 people show up. But you can tell by the sound, because 300 people cannot make the sound of thousands and thousands and tens of thousands like we have. You can't do it. So even though they refuse, you know, normally I'd like it, but I don't. They don't want to move the camera. The only ones that become famous are about six people right behind me. They don't have the best seat in the house, but they're going to become the famous ones. No, but honestly, you know, I know what stadiums sound like, and this sounds like on television, we're in the middle of an Ohio State football game. That's what it sounds like. That's what it sounds like. And speaking of Ohio State, they're not doing too badly, are they, huh? Great coach. They have a great coach, great guy. Great guy. We're standing up for your values. We're standing up for Ohio, and we are proudly standing up for our national anthem. But to continue our momentum, I need you to get your friends, get your family, get your neighbors, get your coworkers and vote Republican. Vote early or on November 6th. Vote Republican. Vote for Steve Chabot, Jim Renacci. Vote for DeWine. We need DeWine. We got to have DeWine. Where the hell is John? Are you over there, John? He's still here. He'll never leave. You got to vote. We need a governor here. You cannot let this happen to Ohio. This Democrat is a disaster, a proven disaster. Vote DeWine. He's a good man, and a good man, too. You got two good men. A vote for a Republican Congress is a vote for more jobs, more wealth, more products made right here in the USA, which is what we're all about. It's a vote to respect our borders, respect our Constitution, and respect the heroes of law enforcement. Thank you, law enforcement. And a vote for Republicans is a vote to reject the Democrat politics of hatred, anger, and division. You've seen that. You just saw it with a high quality, highest quality, this incredible man. You saw it. Brett Kavanaugh, you saw it, what they did to him and his family and his young, beautiful daughters. Right? Donang Dick. How about Donang? Donang Dick. Cory Booker, he ran Newark into the ground. Senator Dianne Feinstein, how about that? How about that? Seriously. Who thinks that Dianne Feinstein leaked the papers? Who thinks? Yeah, that's right. She was very unprepared for that question. No, I didn't leak it. She was very unprepared, right? Very unprepared. Dianne Feinstein. No, what they did to this man, he will go down along with Justice Gorsuch. And by the way, how good is Clarence Thomas? How good? How good? He's going to go down as one of your greats. It's up to the people in this incredible, I don't know if you call it a room. I don't know what the hell it is. All I know. Is this a room or a roof? I think it's a roof. Whatever it is, there are a lot of people. But it's up to you folks. You have the power with your vote to defend your family, your country, your values, your faith, and to defend your dignity. So we had the greatest movement in the history of our country. We really did. We really did. You know, they can say what they want, but nobody even challenges. You know, I'll say that a lot. And usually if there's like a 2% variation, the fake news will hit me the next day. Trump exaggerated or something. Actually, we've under-exaggerated because we produced more than I ever promised during the campaign. More. But we had the greatest — look at this group. We had the greatest — and we never — by the way, I hate to disappoint you, but we went to Mississippi, we went to Missouri, we went to Nevada, we went to every place. And we have crowds. We have tens of thousands of people outside of every arena. They have to start building larger arenas in this country, right? Something is happening. And I saw this in the election. We'd go, I'll never forget, we went to Michigan, final stop. I got there at 1 o'clock in the morning. That was actually election day. 1 o'clock in the morning, there were 32,000 people. I see some people there. They were there. It was unbelievable. 32,000 people. I started speaking at 1 o'clock in the morning. I got home at 4 o'clock in the morning. And I said, you know, we had 32,000. Crooked Hillary had, like, 500. And I said, why aren't we going to win the great state of Michigan? And guess what? We did. We did. And it hadn't been won in decades by a Republican. And now they like me even more. You know why? Because car companies are moving plants back in. And just so you don't feel too lonely, they're moving the plants back into Ohio also. A lot of them. Loyal citizens like you help build this country. And together we are taking back our country. We're returning the power back to the incredible American people. Ohio is the state that gave us a great president who hasn't been properly recognized, okay? William McKinley has not been properly recognized. What he did in terms of trade, in terms of war, but in terms of trade, and I hate to say it, in terms of being smart and tariffs, William McKinley has not been properly recognized, but maybe someday he will. It also gave you a general who was incredible. He drank a little bit too much. You know who I'm talking about, right? So Robert E. Lee was a great general. And Abraham Lincoln developed a phobia. He couldn't beat Robert E. Lee. He was going crazy. I don't know if you know this story. But Robert E. Lee was winning battle after battle after battle, and Abraham Lincoln came home. He said, I can't beat Robert E. Lee. And he had all of these generals. They looked great. They were the top of their class at West Point. They were the greatest people. There's only one problem. They didn't know how the hell to win. They didn't know how to fight. They didn't know how. And one day, it was looking really bad. And Lincoln just said, you hardly knew his name. And they said, don't take him. He's got a drinking problem. And Lincoln said, I don't care what problem he has. You guys aren't winning. And his name was Grant, General Grant. And he went in and he knocked the hell out of everyone. And you know the story. They said to Lincoln, you can't use him anymore. He's an alcoholic. And Lincoln said, I don't care if he's an alcoholic. Frankly, give me six or seven more just like him. He started to win. Grant really did. He had a serious problem, a serious drinking problem. But man, was he a good general. And he's finally being recognized as a great general. But Lincoln had almost developed a phobia because he was having a hard time with a true great fighter and a great general, Robert E. Lee. But Grant figured it out. And Grant is a great general. And Grant came from right here. Ulysses S. Grant. Ohio is the state that gave us the Wright brothers. It gave us Neil Armstrong. He's the man that planted the flag. Think of that. On the face of the moon. Who's that? Who are they? A relative of Neil. That's nice. They weren't worried about not planting a flag, right? You know that. He planted that flag, that American flag, right on the face of the moon. There was no kneeling. There was no nothing. There was no games. There was no games. Boom. Boom. What? Right, fellas? My military guy's up here. Of course, excuse me. My military folks all over this arena. And how do you like the fact that the VA now has choice, right? I said it, but, you know, I skip over it. For 44 years, I've been trying to get choice, and we got it done. That means instead of waiting for 10 days or 5 days or 22 days or 33 days or 2 months, our great veterans, some of them would be fine, just not feeling so good. By the time they saw the doctor, it took so long, they would have a terminal illness. That's how bad it was. And I got done what they've been trying to do for 44 years, I think. 44 years. Now, when they have to wait, they go out, they get the services of a good private doctor, we pay the bill, and they're all better, and that's nice. 44 years. Took 44 years to get that done. I'm just saying that because I see these great military guys. That's pretty much appreciated, fellas, right? It's a big difference. It's a big difference. Made a lot of people very happy. Probably cost us less money. I don't care about that in this case. I care about taking care of our veterans. It's about time. Generations of Ohio workers farmed the fields, poured the incredible steel, fought the battles that made America into the most powerful and prosperous nation in the history of the world. We lost our way, but now we've gained our way back again, bigger and better and stronger than ever before. These courageous Ohio patriots did not shed their blood, sweat, and tears so that we could sit at home while others tried to erase their legacy and destroy our proud American heritage. We didn't do that. For the sake of our freedom and for the sake of our children, we are going to work, we are going to fight, and we are going to win, win, win. That's all we're going to do is win. We will not bend. We will not break. We will never give in. We will never give up. We will never back down. We will never surrender. And we will always fight on to victory. Because we are Americans, and our hearts bleed red, white, and blue. We are one people, one family, and one glorious nation under God. And together, we will make America wealthy again. We will make America strong again. We will make America safe again. And we will make America great again. Thank you, Ohio. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.